Thank you. on the day of Pentecost. You know the way they describe the disciples? They said these men were drunk. And Peter said, it's just 9 a.m. in the morning. We can't be drunk at this hour. We are filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Can I hear someone's Holy Spirit to welcome you? The good news is that this power is for you. Somebody hearing me? The promise of the Father long time ago is that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Wow. And they will see what they have never seen and speak what they have never spoken. They will understand what they never understood. I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Your children will see vision. They will prophesy. They will dream dreams. When the Spirit of the Lord is upon my life, David said, I will dance. I will dance. And you will remember something that happened when God took over David and he was dancing and dancing that he almost went naked. And the wife said, one of them said, look, why are you behaving like your slaves? Why are you behaving? You don't have dignity anymore. You are meant to be a king. And David says, in my father's presence, how can I be a king in my father's presence? How can I see myself as different from the rest when I'm in my father's presence? You see, this is the beauty of the Holy Spirit in a man's life. He doesn't make you segregate yourself from others. He doesn't make you see yourself as better than others. He makes you feel part of others. This is what the Holy Spirit does. When the Spirit of the Lord is upon your life, you see that man, you see that woman, no matter who they are, as one, as brothers, as sisters. And when the Spirit is upon you, there is no big man, small man. No rich, no poor. No white, no black. This is the beauty of the Holy Spirit that must be recovered again in the lives of the believer. We need to recover this beauty again. Because why? Christianity is no longer what the mind of the Father meant it to be. We segregate. We see ourselves as different. We don't see ourselves as brothers and sisters anymore. Because why? We get it to begin to feel that we are better than someone else. No matter how a man is spiritually equipped, it doesn't make him or her see himself or herself as bigger than the rest. He sees it as a privilege that the Holy Spirit has given to you to make life meaningful and beautiful for someone else. This is the beauty of the Spirit of God in your life. And I am saying it's time to rediscover it. Wherever you find conflict, trouble, crisis, it is a sign of the absence of the presence of the Holy Spirit. And wherever the Holy Spirit is not there, there can never be a sustainable peace. There can never be order. We need the Holy Spirit again. The church needs it. If the church can rediscover again the power of the Holy Spirit, they will influence the world and not the world influencing the church. They will teach the world what it means to dwell and rule and reign in the power of the presence of the Holy Ghost. If the church will rediscover again the place of the Holy Spirit in the church, in the life of everyone, right from the Pope, Bishop, priests, deacons, lay people, pastors, whatever your titles may be, if we rediscover again the power of the Holy Spirit, we will change the world. We will tell the world that there is something bigger than them. There is something greater. We need to rediscover this power again. Can someone say, Holy Spirit, we need you.
Spirit, we need you.
And I hear you say it again and again.
Holy Spirit, we need you.
This is what Jesus says in John chapter 7. From verse 10 to 7. As I lead you to hear what Jesus said, again, I want to remind you that the Holy Spirit is not a special gift for special people. No. The Holy Spirit is not a special ministry given to special people. Mm-mm. The Holy Spirit is not reserved for priests, pastors. The Holy Spirit is for you. Can I get someone say for me? And one thing I have come to discover about the extent a man can go with the Holy Spirit is the extent of his or her hunger for the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit. The extent you will go depends on the extent of your hunger. When a man is truly and deeply yearning for the presence and power of the Holy Spirit, his life will change. His story will change. A man met me after the mass today. He said, Father, I didn't know God is like this. I said, you have not seen anything. He said, I have come too late. I said, no, now you are seen. He said, one of the child whose result has been heard for years. They have done everything to recover it, nothing. Just within this period, she found that result. They said, come, your result is ready. I said, you don't know what you are missing. Disconnecting yourself from the presence and power of the Holy Spirit. I told you during the week, nobody's too old to discover this gift. I'm talking about an old man, at least he's advanced, the legend is advanced in age. And he said, I didn't know this life is this sweet. He's been a Christian for years, but now he's saying, I didn't know this life can be this sweet. I am telling you, the heaviness in your life, the lack of satisfaction you feel when you go to church is simply because there is a disconnection between you and the source of life. Get to know him. Get to love him. Get to desire him. Come on, there is so much for you to benefit from your life with the Holy Spirit. There is so much for you to benefit. And I will say again and again, any man who will remain standing to the end will only succeed because of one person, the Holy Spirit. And no man and nobody who has started this race should not finish this race. Don't ever let it be said of you that you can't finish the race. Can I hear someone say, I will run to the finish? Can I hear you shout it? I will run to the finish. I have seen priests quitting their ministry. I have seen reverend sisters quitting their apostolate. I have seen pastors giving up their assignment. I have even seen bishops turning away. It simply means that it doesn't matter the position people get to. What sustains a man's life is the Holy Spirit. We call it the oil. The oil of God that falls upon a man to soften him when it's getting too hot. We call it the water, the living water that falls upon a man to refresh his drooping spirit. We call the Holy Spirit the fire that energizes a man when he's becoming deep, weak, helpless, confused. We call it the fire that comes again to reactivate a man's faith and set him again on the race. We call the Holy Spirit the wind that after the heat of life, it comes to cool your life. When tension, when trouble, when crisis, when confusion sets into your life, the Holy Spirit becomes the cool that makes you feel calm in the midst of all of these problems. Can the church join me to say, Holy Spirit, we welcome you.
Holy Spirit, we welcome you.
Now let's look at John chapter 7, from verse 37. Are you there? John 7, from 37. You must get into a covenant with the Holy Spirit today. I don't know what covenant you want to enter with him. But you should. John 7, I don't mind if somebody will read it and read loud and clear enough and shout it out.
On the last and most important day of the festival.
On the last and most important day of the festival, which is today for us, we've been on this journey for the past 9 days. And today is the 10th day and the last day of this journey. There is something about the last day. The most important thing the scripture describes this moment. On this most important day, the greatest day you can imagine, that God decided to showcase his plan to the world. No longer meant for the 12, but for the world. On that most important day, on that great day, the disciples stood out to proclaim the lordship of Jesus. And the people gathered to listen to them. Scripture says so many were converted to the point that they said, what shall we do? What shall we do? And this is the good news about the presence of God when he moves and functions in a man's life. He wants to know, what shall I do? You shouldn't let this moment pass you by without asking the Holy Spirit, what shall I do? What do you want from me? What does heaven want me to do? How can I glorify what he wants me to do? Ask him, there will be answer. Because at this moment in your life, you are so special to the Holy Spirit. You're so special to heaven because of the deposit that has been deposited in you. Because of the power that has been placed upon your life. On that last day, what happened? See, Jesus stood up and in a loud voice. When sometimes you see a man speak loudly, he doesn't want anybody to miss the message. In a loud voice, that all who will hear will not miss the message. That kind of action attracts and cuts away distraction. What Jesus did was to draw everyone's attention to himself. He stood and he cried aloud. Let's hear what the Lord said. If everyone is thirsty, hear the good news. And that's what I said from the beginning. The gift of the Holy Spirit is not for any particular person. The Lord says, if anyone is thirsty, what should he do? Come to me. And that's what you see. That the Lord will pay attention to those who come to him. Really? This is where the lot of Christians are missing out. They are too distracted. They are too occupied with so many things but not God. They can spend every time they have doing other things but not the things of God. Jesus said, are you testing? Testing for what? For power. For life. For grace. Whatever of God you are testing for. He said, are you testing? And this is what the Lord has been leading us through. To create the hunger in us. Are you testing? Then Jesus said, come. Come to me. And then he said, the key to drinking from this cup of power is in your believing. If any man believes in me, let him drink. So you see why I keep saying to you that you are a privileged one of God. Why? The Holy Spirit, you must have heard me say it, and I say it again, is not for the world. The world cannot receive him. It's for you. Come on, everybody, say for me. It's for you. Why is he for you? Because you believe. The key to getting into the life of the Holy Spirit is believing in Jesus. When you believe in him, you come to him. And as you come to him, you begin to drink. We are going to drink to our satisfaction today. Say amen. I said we are going to drink to our satisfaction today. When you begin to drink, what comes out of you? there is something that comes out of him when you begin to drink this kind of drink. Oh, hallelujah. I just feel so excited, you know. Something comes out of you. Let's hear what the word says about what comes out of you.
As the scripture says, a life-giving water will come out of the sand.
Number one, strength. Strength. Is your life a deceptive place? Is your life unfruitful? He says, when you begin to drink, something I want to teach you that you need to know. You see, this is your entire life, body, soul, spirit, everything about you. This is your body. The only thing you can see and feel is your body. Then you look at yourself, right? But you see, this body carries so much. This body can carry so much. You can get something into it that can control the entire system. Now let me give this example. You carry alcohol. And I mean serious alcohol, and you begin to drink into your body. After how many minutes or few seconds, depends on your own body, what happens? Your body begins to react. How did it happen? What is the connection? That tells you that the body is connected to a lot of things. That is just alcohol. That is just alcohol. What about when the power of the Holy Spirit takes over your body? How will you react? How will your body begin to react to it? I have delved into the things of the Spirit by the grace of the Spirit, helping me to understand more and more the secret things of the Spirit. How the evil ones, without getting to you, can blow affliction and sickness into your body and it will stay. How is it happening? I want to bring out something so that you understand your spiritual makeup. Because you don't understand, the enemy are taking advantage of it and they are using it more against you. They are using it to create and steal your joy, to kill your happiness, to siphon every good coming into your life because you don't understand that there is a connection between your body and the things of the Spirit. An evil person is standing somewhere and is blowing something and it gets into your body. And before you know it, something begins to deteriorate in your life. In some cases, there is no test, no laboratory that will detect it, but something is wrong. In some cases, doctors have been frustrated. They say, we have done everything and carried out every test. We can't find anything, but you know that there is something. In some cases, you will detect. You'll be able to see the things wrong, but you don't even know where it came from. How did it enter your body? How did it begin? Because there is a correlation between your body and spiritual thing. Now I am saying this because you need to understand why you must continually come under the power of the Holy Spirit, drinking of the spiritual water, so that there will be no accommodation for whatever any false spirit has to represent in your life. The life of man does not avoid vacuum. Something must occupy it. You must learn to drink of this.
pure fountain. And how do you begin to drink of this spiritual fountain? Do you know that every time you sit right before the Eucharistic Jesus, you're drinking? But then you have to be conscious, because the truth is, if you pour water on a covered bottle, the water passes through the body but never inside, because it's not open. So when you come into the presence of the Lord, when you come to worship the Lord, have a mindset that you are about to drink from the fountain of life. The fountain that occupies your entire life in order to deoccupy anything that is not of God. Look, you can expel what is not of God out of your life when you begin to learn how to fill what is inside of you with the fountain from above. Don't worry, some may think yes, maybe this understanding knowledge is coming too late. I wish I knew from the beginning. It doesn't matter. Start from where you are now, because the battle does not end with age. And one thing I want to say to you, some of you that they are not able to bring down in your youthful age, they are waiting for you in your old age. Some of you, why? Because in your youthful age, you are still, you know, you're coming to the Lord, you're making every effort. As you're growing old, don't diminish, increase. As you are growing old, you need to occupy and fill yourself, because now you will not have enough physical energy, but you can have enough spiritual power. Because the battle is not just for the young, the battle is for everyone. But you need to get yourself to be conscious of what you are capable of when you learn how to drink from the fountain. So don't give room, that's what I'm saying. So let other things begin to occupy you when you can actually occupy with what is spiritual, what is of God. That's why you must give time to the things of God. It's very important. You must give time. The destruction of the enemy is for a purpose. The world will distract you. The world will offer you things, because they know if we succeed to distract you, we can succeed to deposit our property. Let me give another example of how it works. If, for example, China wants to fight Israel, and Israel wants to fight China, they can't fight from their territory, because there are two different territories far apart. They don't have the right to throw anything through on that territory to that territory. The first thing is, they must look for somewhere to occupy. Somewhere to occupy. Somewhere they know that they can get to where they want to get to. Now, this is also the way the enemies operate, and also the things of the spirit. They look for somewhere to occupy. They may not be able to get into your territory, but they can get through someone who is close to your territory. So you see why you got to be alert and get yourself filled and occupied. They can get through someone's territory. They get into another person's territory, they can get to you. So that's why you see Eagle Fest as a family. Where there is no unity of purpose, of prayer, of desire, you will discover that the enemy can take over any territory to get what he wants. That is why, as a spiritual man or woman, you must also fight to occupy your territory and the territory around you, surround it with the fire of the Holy Spirit, so that when the enemy will ever dare to come near the territory they want to get to you, they will discover that it's already occupied. Hallelujah. The spiritual life is a deep mystery. But I know that's why Jesus said the Holy Spirit will help you to understand. And I am saying that deeper knowledge will be given to you. Where you were defeated yesterday, you will not be defeated today. Is somebody hearing me? Wherever they defeated you yesterday, at any point, I said, because of what you are receiving today, you will not be defeated a second time. Hallelujah. So Jesus said, all of this brought us to, when you begin to drink, what you begin to produce. What comes out of you are not just empty, they have power. They are also spiritual powers for engaging in spiritual warfare. When you drink, something comes out of you. That's why when someone who carries the grace of God upon his life, if an unwanted person comes near, they know that there is a grace in your life. They know. That's why if they cannot get to you, they want to get to another territory. So that they break you through that territory, they get in. May God fortify all the territories around you. Talking about territories, I'm also talking about your husband, your wife, your children, your friends, those who are dear to you, close to you, they are your territory. The enemies are on their own. It's easier to push them somewhere, but I'm talking about the territories that surround you. So while you pray and get connected, please remember also to raise a wall of protection around the other territory so that the enemy cannot shoot through that territory to get to you. You know for sure that it is much more harder to watch the pains of those we love than to bear our own pain. Jesus said it. Many people have been injured, wounded, because some of their territory has been affected. They lost the ground. And because they lost the ground, they were able to attack them. Secure your territory, child of God. No matter what you feel, please remember this message. Secure your territory. Hallelujah. Now, we'll keep speaking. Streams will flow out. Streams of living water. It was Prophet Ezekiel that saw the vision of the water that, will come, that was coming out from the sanctuary. He said, from the right side of the Lord came water. And you see, he said, everywhere the water goes, and whatever it touches, life. Life begins to spring up. Anything it touches, it makes it whole. This is the beauty of moments like this, because springs come out of living water, When God's servants start to pray, springs of life is coming out. And when there is someone to receive, as he begins to receive it, life begins to again resuscitate. And someone says, I am so blessed. Streams of living water will flow right from inside. And let me tell you, what this streams of living water does is like a two-edged sword. It's like a two-edged sword. It purifies and it cuts. It strengthens and it destroys. When God was speaking to Jeremiah, when he said, I have appointed you to plant, to build, he also said to pull down and to destroy. This is what comes out of any man who comes to know God. Because listen, the spiritual life, I have told you many times, it is a preparatory ground for you to be able to engage in spiritual warfare. Powers are fighting you day after day, whether you know it or not. Whether you know it or not. I'm sure I told you, and I told you a good one of the project prayer. A little girl who had a dream after the first day or second day of this life in the spirit center program. And she saw herself with one of her sisters. She said she does not even recognize her physically, but she knew in the dream that it was a sister. Changed in the room. And a man would come with another man, and they would come and be feeding them there. And at the point, they brought one useless food. And this one said, no, we are not eating again. They said, if you don't eat, you are going to remain here forever. So you better eat. Even the enemy will feed you in order to sustain you so they can do what they are doing and using what they are using for you. Their food is not to strengthen you. Their food is to weaken you. Empower you so that you can't even escape. So, and he was asking this man, when are we going to leave? He said, you better remember, there is no hope of leaving. She woke up. And she told her mother, I said, Mom, I'm confused. Look at the dream I had. And the mother called and said, look at the dream. In fact, I think I was heavy in my eye when he called. At first, I wasn't even getting the message well. Then later, something struck my spirit. I said, where is she? I think I better talk to her. And then I talked to her and she shared it. And the Holy Spirit said, immediately I need you to get them out of that place. People walk physically, but they are actually in prison. People are moving about. You see, the Lord once told me, there is no body that does not have a star. And I have also told him once, wherever there is a star, there is an arrow to shoot the star. You don't need to offend somebody. You don't need to make somebody unhappy. No. It is just their business. And I have told you, stop worrying about the business of your enemies. When you worry about their business, you are distracting yourself from your own business. God has also given you a business to carry out. You have the power to trample upon scorpions and snakes and all the powers of the enemy. That is your assignment. Why are you complaining when the enemy are doing the assignment? When they are fleeting, when they are tormenting, you do Because why? There is power in you. Get to be confident in your power, in the power of God that is in you. You have to. So, we decided to pray. And as the Lord said, she was transported back into that spirit where she was actually there with the person she was calling the sister. Still in chain with the powers that was monitoring and watching over them. And so now she knew, out of herself now, with the Spirit of God aiding her, what happened. I said, ask this man, why are we here? And he said, look, this is how we pick up children and use their destiny. Everything God exposes is to build our knowledge and prepare our mind so we know how to deal with it. I just imagine how many children's destiny have been disrupted. People sometimes will say, what is the meaning of that? They say that because they don't understand what goes on in the spirit. They just think they sleep and wake up and move about, and that's all. The potential God put inside every man is 100%. But the truth is, we are not able to achieve it. So, and then I said, ask God, are we the only one here? He said, no, there are other people who also go about to feed children and use their destiny. The enemies are using what is yours to do this, and it has to stop. Can someone say it has to stop? No, they are using what is yours to do with it. Destiny, now you are using it to oppress. You are using it for something else. It has to stop. And the only way to stop is that we must bring everyone under the authority and power of the Holy Spirit again. That's why I said it's time to recover what we have lost. And the Holy Spirit is willing to do that. So, as we were doing that and praying, we asked the Holy Spirit, the Lord, to descend down the sword. As soon as one of them saw the sword, he wanted to run. I said, pursue him. There is no escape. Pursue. As they pursued, slain that one, and the other one was begging, we will let you go. You can now go. But please don't kill me. No. They must be destroyed, because when an enemy begs you, it's not because he wants to set you free. He begs you to lure you in order to do more. Because every time you free yourself a bit, you anger them. Every time you get away, you anger them. So when they are tormented, they say, please, I will let you go. They let you go and you let them go. They will go and reorganize. Hallelujah. Why are we talking about this? The Lord says there is a spring that will come out of you if only you drink. And this spring will enable you to defeat the powers that are also out to destroy you. Child of God, together we can win this battle. Say amen. Yeah. And that's why I need you to endure. Be strong when you are growing weak and tired. Please come to the Lord. He said, come to me. There will be times you're going to be tired because you are carrying treasure in a weak vessel. There will be times there will be a crack. Whenever you see the crack, come to the one who knows how to mend your crack. Whenever there is something that has punctured that vessel of yours, come to the organizer of your life. He will seal up that hole and then you can move again. Don't allow yourself to be deflated to the point that you cannot move well. When the tire of the vehicle is completely deflated, no matter how much you throttle, it cannot meet up the speed that the car is made for. Because why? Something has been punctured. Everything you keep hearing is noise. The car, you are just, even you yourself will get frustrated by the noise you hear. That is why many people are frustrated by the things happening in their lives. Because they didn't even know that they have been punctured. So when they hear all of this and see all these problems and all these crises, they get frustrated. In their frustration, they are ready to even abandon the car and trek or even go back. Can I hear a child of God say no more frustration? So just know that whenever you feel angry, you get angry at the things happening in your life, and I mean the kind of anger that is not even driving you to drink, but the kind of anger that is pushing you away and making you feel you don't need God anymore, please, your spiritual strength has been punctured. You've got to find the fertilizer to once again seal that hole. And when it seals the hole, it breathes into you again the life of the Holy Spirit. And when it breathes into you, you find yourself bouncing again. Hallelujah. You find yourself bouncing again. And you begin to regain moving the speed that you are made for. Don't let your tiredness be a distraction, but rather let it draw you to the spring of life, where he says he will revive your drooping spirit. And someone say hallelujah. So I said to you, child of God, this Holy Spirit is for you. It's for who?
For me.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready? Something is going to change in your mind.
Yes.
I'm telling you, on hearing, you see, what you are about to receive will manifest at different times in different people's lives. Are you hearing me? Remember when I prayed for gifts of the Holy Spirit, the Lord didn't manifest unto many years. The gift of tongues did not even manifest until over 15 years. Many of the gifts you experience, it may not manifest openly immediately, but what it means is that keep nurturing it until the day of manifestation. Because many a times this is the discouragement of some of God's children. Hey, see the other person. No. As long as there is a yearning and hunger, there is a feeling already. So I am saying something will really change in somebody's mind. There is no when the Holy Spirit comes that something does not happen. Physically, spiritually. Nowhere. When Paul and Silas were in prison, what happened when the Spirit came? Chains broke. Padlock broke. Gate opened. When Paul and Peter and John met a cripple at the beautiful gate, and they said, look, we have nothing, but what we have, we will give you. Something happened. He leapt for joy. God is still God. As he was yesterday, so he is today. And as he comes again in power upon your life, something is going to happen to you. I know that powers are going to be broken. I know that chains are going to be shattered. I know that afflictions are going to be lifted. I know that somebody will be revived again. I know that habits will be broken. I know that something will happen. Can I hear someone say, I am ready? If you are, then please answer your feet. I just want to thank you.
Precious Holy Spirit, I'm here just for you. You
You see what I cannot see? You know what I don't know? I just hear testing. Your children need you. Your church needs you. Your ministers need you. The authority of your church needs you. Your children need you again, Holy Spirit. I need you. Open your eyes. He's coming. And open your heart. Is flowing to you. The living water from the Eucharistic side of Jesus is flowing for you.
Seven times. Just keep your mind. Please say,
I call on you now to feel the strength. I call on your power to feel your children. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. You are so powerful. Let nothing about me remain. Let everything about you be all is mine. Holy Spirit, flow, flow, flow with your power.
Thank you, Holy Spirit! is a spiritual exercise. You are going to breathe in. When I tell you breathe in, you breathe in. And you breathe out. The atmosphere is saturated with power. And as you breathe in, something will happen. There's going to be an explosion inside of you. Get ready. Thank you, Holy Spirit, as you occupy this arena. Get ready. Breathe in the Holy Spirit power now. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in.
Thank you. It's flowing inside of you.
Receive the gifts, receive them, receive them. Go now. As that what you have received will be protected. song. Lord, thank you. Thank you. Congratulations. Congratulations. We're going to conclude the next few minutes. I told you to write your needs. I hope you did what you asked of me. Your gift first. I told you write the gifts you want more in your life. And I'm going to ask you to keep praying with that gift. I will still pray about it on Tuesday when we will be enjoying the Lord in the meeting. So still keep praying over the gifts. And you're free to share your experiences with others, the beautiful experiences. And may God bless and honor you. This is a promise, not from me, but from him whom I am his mouthpiece. And the enemy will not rule over your lives again. Bring them to the place of blessings. Yeah. This fight is not our prayers in our necessities, but deliver us from all dangers, whoever glorious and blessed Virgin Mary. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord.
Holy Spirit,
for our freshness, Holy Spirit.